One thing the US election has highlighted are the great strides made over the last 50 years by the civil rights movement, which some say began in 1955, when Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on a bus. Mothra Bogor spoke to someone who was there that night.
Mr. Blake, you were a bus driver with Montgomery Bus Service for 29 years.
Yes, sir.
And you were, in fact, the bus driver on the night Mrs. Parks refused to stand up for a white passenger.
Yes, sir, that is correct.
Now, you, in fact, asked her to give up her seat based on the colour of her skin.
I can sit here and lay my hand on my heart and swear to you that I did not notice the colour of that woman's black skin.
It played no part in you asking her to stand up.
I did not ask her to stand up. I asked her to move to the back of the bus.
Why?
Well, I thought she would enjoy it back there. She had friends back there. I thought she'd enjoy sitting and talking.
How did you know that she had friends back there?
Well, they was all Negro. I thought they'd have a lot in common.
When Mrs. Parks didn't give up her seat and didn't move to the back of the bus, you called police and you had her arrested.
I wasn't doing anything to that woman except my job. The dang bus was full and she wouldn't move to the back.
On the plus side, it led to the civil rights movement in your country.
Yes, yes, I'm sure under different circumstances, Ms. Parks and I would have got on like a cross on fire. I admire and respect that woman and have since learned a lot about her. In fact, my family and I, we went down and we looked at that statue they none of her at the National Statuary Museum.
Yes, it's a lovely statue, isn't it? And it's a wonderful honour.
Yeah, but have you ever noticed that statue they done of her? They got her standing up.